Hello, I'm Mr. Arnold, your editor, lecturer in metallurgy. And here I want to stress the importance of the prophets and of the saint, and what is the difference between them. Most of the church people don't know that John the Baptist, he was a witness to the light and not the light. And he was not a saint, but a prophet. So here is the relationship between the two. So this is a Saint John the Baptist. He was a prophet. Prophet are the whip master for the rabbis. If anything go wrong or anything, they give them the guidance, you know. Moses came and gave them the scripture, moral laws. And same in India, Ramchandra came. And so Krishna come here. And here is the saint, the very primary source of light, the Christ. And this Jesus told to Nicodemus in John 3 that those who are below, this is below, they read scripture and they go by scripture, what is written. They themselves can't say anything. They are the disciples of their rabbis. Whatever rabbi tell them, they think it is 100% true. Whereas the saint here above, here, what we say, we say it from our heart and not any book, you know. So we say with authority what we have found. Here you are taught by God. Here you are taught by God. Here you are taught by a moral teacher. To put the moral teacher right, prophets come to guide them, to tell them, this is the way. They lay down the scripture for them, like Moses laid down the law. So here, we are twice born. The twice born, we have a covenant with our bridegroom, Christ Jesus. In this dark age, the guide or the model come Christ Jesus. And he is the very Son of God, called Christ. And he introduced to us our supernatural Father. So then we have covenant with our supernatural Father, and he teaches us what to say. And here you go logically. So logo is his word. So whatever we speak is based upon logical reasoning. For example, a Jew is one who is inwardly. Jew is one who is inwardly of heart, not outwardly. Outwardly, they are tribal people. Some are Judah tribe, Benjamin tribe, Levi tribe. This is Adam, and this is God inside. So, what is born is to die. So, people of Judah tribe are born, people of Levi tribe born, and in the Holocaust, then the same people died, those who were born. Not a single Jew died. So here it is. Under Adam, you have races, under races tribes and surnames and other things. So this planet Earth is for the habitation of the sons of Adam. So you must build your covenant with Adam. And Abraham was an ideal Adam. He was picked from the Iraq area to settle in the Middle East as ideal Adam, Sarah as Eve, and they were given the promised land as Garden of Eden. So far they were faithful to Abraham and Yahweh. It was a land of honey and milk. As soon as they become unfaithful, the same land become barren. Remember, Jacob had 12 sons. Out of the 12, only Joseph was the salt of Abraham. He was telling the truth to Jacob. The other 11, they were telling lies to Jacob. And they were liars. So they were not salt of Abraham, 11. Only one was the salt of Abraham, it was Joseph. And so far he was the salt of Abraham. They were eating very meager food, sustainer. As soon as they sold him as a slave, the land became barren and no food, hungry. That is what says Abraham is the father of the faithful, not of the unfaithful. Father protects you from enemy and other thing. So if you become unfaithful to your father, you become in an orphan, no protection at all. So the chosen people, they become unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, and they are anti-Semitic. They can't build their covenant with Abraham if they become Jew outwardly. Because Abraham was not a Jew outwardly, he was Jew of heart. In fact, he was a saint. Abraham was a saint, a noble man. He is at the company of Melchizedek, a sadhu. So he was a saint, or what we call Har Har Mahadev. So the prophets come to whip master for the rabbis if they're doing wrong thing, or give them guidance, you know, as Moses laid down the Ten Commandments. And so if the people go astray, then the rabbi sitting in the name of Moses, they will whip them and bring them back. Or they are sitting in the seat of Moses, in the synagogue or in a temple or anywhere. So that's why Jesus said, do what they tell you to do, but don't follow their example. Because they say something, but they themselves don't practice. So they became crook by the time Christ Jesus appeared. And he tried to revive them, because when you are crook cheating people, then Satan is here. God is out. When God is out, then you will cheat people, fleece people. Whereas in among the Samaritans, they were not cheating or anything like that. So God was in their hearts. And their moral laws were perfect, needing no improvement or anything. Whereas the moral law of the chosen people, they were corruption, lot of corruptions. So they needed light to put it right. Light came among its own, Christ Jesus, and they loved darkness. So this is the relationship, you know, between light and scripture. So this is the oral Torah, which is the taproot, which is His word that Jesus came to deliver. And this is scripture, which you can read. This you read, this you perceive. That's why Jesus said they see, they read the holy books, but they did not perceive the root of the holy books. So this oral Torah lacks nothing, but this scripture lacks oral Torah. If you don't have the knowledge of the oral Torah, then you are teaching the dead letters of the scripture. That's why Jesus said, let the dead bury their dead. Among the Samaritans, they had this knowledge of the oral Torah, and their tree of life was green, not dead. That's why a Samaritan woman at well, she challenged Jesus, and she had a deep discussion with Jesus that even surprised the laborers of Jesus. So she was St.Photina, but those five husbands, they are not spiritual. Sorry, they are not physical, they are spiritual. And they are well known in India, where the second coming of Jesus came in the name of Nanak. So this is the tree of life. Among the Samaritan, it was green, and that's why the Samaritan man picked up the wounded person and looked after him on philanthropic basis. Whereas the dead in Holy Spirit, they passed by, let him die. So, letter killeth, spirit giveth life. This is spirit. Many things I can tell, but not many customers. They love darkness. Here you are. This is the situation. These menorah, these three candles here, three candles here, they are the pots. And they are lit by the middle candle, which is of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, our supernatural father. So these are creation of Demiurg, Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, same thing, Lord of the nature. So the soul comes from our supernatural father. So soul is the dominant factor in our human life. If soul is gone, you are dead. So that's why Jesus said, the Jesus represented the Christ and Jesus represented the middle candle of the menorah of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, our living father. So that's why he was the Lord of the Sabbath, because of this key soul in you. So these three candles are social, ecumenical, and political affairs. Some are holy, some are evil. So you can see this menorah represents the our secular affairs, all the secular affairs. Jesus, when he was to be born among the chosen people, because they were spiritually sick, and Jesus was the doctor, he could not take a normal birth among the people of Judah tribe, which were the most satanic people, and he wanted to take birth among them. So he had to take birth in a virgin of Judah tribe. But the light came among you, among his own, but his own loved the darkness. So they rejected the light which Jesus offered to them. So the prophet come to put the moral laws on sound basis with full knowledge of the oral Torah. That is, Moses himself saw the face of God and he showed the back to the people. Back is reflection. In Christ Jesus, we are the very source of light. We are of the primary source, which is this one. That's why Jesus came to make us the sons of the Most High, of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. And this is of Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda. This is of Demiurge, and this is of the real one. So, Christ is the son of the Elohim, and Jesus was the son of Heavenly Father, Yahweh. Flesh, your heart, this is a part. And this is of flesh. On flesh apply the moral laws, and you have the scripture. Going against the moral law is sin. So here sins are committed. And the rabbis is the one who governs these sins, and he punishes them by giving them the fine. Go and bathe here and there, and make them, you know, get fed up with the thing, so next time they don't do it wrong thing. But this blasphemy is against the Holy Spirit, which originates from your heart. At Tony Blair and Bush, Lala Gandhi in India, Jinnah, all those people who did the partition of India, they were all hypocrites. So there is the hypocrites here and sinners here. To expose the hypocrite, as in the temple priests were hypocrites. When Jesus gave the last parable of the wine press, they knew that it applies to them. But they won't admit it. So these hypocrites, they are psychic. They can give sugar-coated sermons to cool the client away. But as you know, so this is the introduction to the prophets and the saint. Prophets are the moral teachers, and going against the moral law is called sin, and going against the Holy Spirit, which originates, sits in your heart, because this is the temple of God. God sits here. If your heart is clean, if you are cheating people, then Satan is here and God is out. So this Tony Blair and Bush, when they said that Saddam Hussein has weapon of mass destruction, they knew very well that he has none at all. But they wanted to destroy Iraq. That was the homeland of Abraham. Yahweh picked up a good stalk, root stalk, to sow in the Middle East as Adam. So what Yahweh did, they undid it, or they uprooted what Yahweh did. So they destroyed humanity by attacking the Iraq area. So Putin is going to sort them up. Putin is a man who is not a hypocrite. What is inside is outside, like Nanthio. So he's going to sort them and bring this atomic war. In 2023, it is expected on 14 May 2023 or soon after. Israel will not see its 76th birthday. So many more things I have discovered. It's all come here. You have to search your own heart. Remember the woman who lost the coin? Then she lit the lamp of His Word. And she searched all over. When she found it, she was very happy. That is God when you find it. So people of discerning intellect will know everything. So far, they are not greedy. If they are greedy and hypocrite like Tony Blair and Bush, they are sons of Satan. If they are not greedy and hypocrite like Putin, then they are sons of man. And sons of man are taken up by Okay, we finish here, and